you. Good afternoon. First of all, she's gone. We would like to thank Inese for inviting us here to this interesting event. It's my actually first time in Riga. I'm very happy to be here because we are very close by, but you know, there's never time to visit Riga. So the school is amazing, the city is amazing. It's a great pleasure to be among all of you. And our topic is, as Inese already introduced, is about consumer credit. We would like to present the overview of the Lithuanian experience. Where is the... Ah, here it is. Okay. Not there. But it should be working, yeah. Okay, so since the basis of regulation in Lithuania is based on the EU directive, it can be an example for other European Union countries, but we did not choose to talk about how the directive was implemented. We rather chose to show what happened in Lithuania after few legislative changes were introduced. As 5 years ago, Lithuania faced some serious problems in this area. The market was quite open and flexible, while consumers were not very financially cautious. And at the end of 2014, almost one-fourth of all the credits issued to the consumers were overdue. The amount of the debt was almost 100 million euros. So our approach is maybe a little bit unorthodox because we are lawyers, but we first of all will give you the statistics, the most representative numbers, which show how the market changed after the changes to the law were introduced. So I will cover this part. Then Danguole, who is the totally number one of the consumer law expert in Lithuania for a long time, will talk about these legislative changes. And then I will talk briefly about the situation with dispute resolution in this area. So let's start from the first figure. So from the number of consumer credit agreements, we can see already that through 2013 and 2015, there are over 1 million credit consumer credit agreements concluded in Lithuania, while in 2016 and 17, this number does not exceed 500,000 agreements per year. So this is the first indication that there was a quite considerable change in this area. If we look at the numbers in euros, we divided these numbers based on the credit agreements. You can disregard the overdrafts because the numbers are too small and these agreements are too rare. But we rather divide them into linked credits, which are credit that consumers take when they buy a particular thing. And the credit is linked to a particular thing. And then to free credits, which are, you know, free money, which you can use whatever you want. So in Lithuania, these are divided in statistical data into credits for less than 290 euros and for more than 290. Why this number? Because before the euro was introduced, it was 1,000 liters, and it's now changed because the statistics began with dividing these credits These credits for less than 290 euros are also called small or quick credits or payday loans. So this is the most sensitive area. So from this chart, you can see that the market of linked credits, it gradually increasing during the year. So the whole period of 5 years, these credits are increasing. While you can see that free credits, it was like a Achilles heel in Lithuania. So the both areas took a hit in 2016. Both the credits for less than 290 and credits for more than 290 euros. So these free credits for more than 290 grew a little bit in 2017, but they did not reach the level which existed in 2015, when the market was the most active, the biggest number of credits were issued. And if we look at the overdue payments, and here I show only the payments which are overdue for more than 90 days. If we look at the data with overdue credits for more than 60 or 30 days, the data is maybe more drastic, but these are the most painful credits. So we can see already that the debt was increasing from 2013, and in 2016 it decreased considerably, maybe not with not a very big change, but it was important. And then this important change with a decrease in debt is obvious in 2017. And also, we wanted to show the data on the payday loans market, the most sensitive area, where you know if we talk about in day-to-day terms. So these are people who usually take loans to gamble or to pay for some things that cannot for day to day things, and they are not very financially cautious. So this market was very much affected. And first of all, you can see that the change is seen in number of credit agreements and number of consumers. So it's now almost the same. It means that one consumer usually does not enter into more than one consumer agreement, which was the practice in Lithuania when consumer entered into a chain of credit agreements in order to cover the former debt. So these agreements was concluded just to cover the previous one. So the difference in 2013 actually was 500,000 agreements were entered into by the same consumer, while in 50,000, while in 2017 the difference is only 5,000. Overdue payments also in numbers, in number of overdue agreements, and if we count it in euros, it also you can see the decrease in 2015 and 2016. So this is not the whole data which is gathered by the Bank of Lithuania, which is which is responsible for the for this market, but these are the most representative numbers, and the question is from this data is for Danguole what the hell happened in 2015 and 16 in this market. So I give you the floor.
Thank you. Thank you very much. So Egle, it was a very good question. And the question really is whether this situation in the market was related to the legal regulation or changes in legal regulation. So let's talk about legal regulation. So Egle, if you can see another slide. So in Lithuania, consumer credit is regulated by separate law, law on consumer credit, and which was adopted in 2000 and came into force in 2011. And previous everything was regulated by civil code, but later our politicians decided that it is not enough to have only material norms regulated which regulates consumer credit agreements, but we need some procedural norms. So now we have separate law, and this law was changed four times, and actually the law in 2011 and 2015, these laws introduced considerable changes to law on consumer credit. And the law in 2011, the changes was mainly related to institutional changes, and before the all financial sector supervisory function of whole financial sector were related to were assigned to the Consumer Protection Authority. After that, to Lithuanian Bank, or Bank of Lithuania, as Egle mentioned, and so now this field is under supervision of Lithuanian Bank. And the second change was related to maximum annual percentage rate of charge, so-called APR, and it was decreased from 2,050% to 150% to 200%. But actually, as we saw from the market, did not reflect these changes, and nothing changed in the market. And the law of 2015, actually, there was more changes, and there was established additional restriction to the advertising of the consumer credit agreements. There was made some changes in responsible lending regulation and maximum APR regulation, and additional new restrictions were established related to the conclusion of credit agreement. There was new institute introduced, so-called the stop list. The list of person, I would say in very simple way, the list of person who do not want to borrow just. And some changes in penalization procedure were made, especially related to monetary penalties, and they increased. And on some occasions, they were related to annual income, and new requirements for peer-to-peer lending were established in the law. And so let's talk a bit about some of these institutes and changes in responsible lending regulation. So there was changed the principle, and earlier was trust in consumer information principle, and now it is, I would say, double check principle, because credit provider for them is not enough to just to rely on the consumer information provided by the consumer, but it should check everything in registers and information bases, and they are responsible for this checking. And in case consumer provider breach obligation to evaluate credit worthiness of the consumer, so consumer should not, or for the consumer does not apply any penalties in case of late payments and any charges payable for default. And this debt to income ratio, or debt to income principle, we had earlier, and there was no changes in that. However, There was some consideration, this rule was considered by administrative courts, and they decided that this rule does not comply with the law because there is no possibility to evaluate individual situation of the specific or concrete consumer. And later on, there was this rule was a bit changed, but in some exceptional cases, individual cases, this principle cannot, might be not applied, where credit provider could prove that the principle of responsible lending is not violated in this particular particular case. And this compliance with this principle and this area of consumer credit were supervised very carefully by Lithuanian Bank. And actually, one of the most popular, I could say, sanction is sanction for the breach of this obligation. And the highest fine was about 44,000 euros. So the second institute we would like to discuss our changes in maximum APR regulation. So as you could see, there was maximum rate 200%. However, this principle was changed and in two rules or two separate criteria. And now the total cost of the credit would be considered as unfair if consumer credit borrowing rate exceeds 75% and other costs which are included in the total cost of credit exceeds 0.04% of total amount payable by the consumer. And the second criteria, the total cost exceed total amount payable by the consumer. And actually the consequences, there is no certainty about the consequences, and there is discussion whether should apply unfair terms institute or whether it should apply specific consequence indicated in the loan consumer credit. Actually, there is indicated that the court has discretion to reduce the total amount of the credit. And still, there is not clear court practice on this issue. So the third institute, so restriction of the conclusion of the consumer credit. And we could call this restriction as ratione personae and ratione temporis. So that means no credit agreements for persons under age 18 and no credit agreements for incapacitated persons and no credit agreements during the night from 10 p.m. to 7 a.m. And there was introduced some additional institute, cooling off institute for 2 days, not 14 days as it is in directive. It is applied, understandable, but it's like additional restriction and consumer, or not maybe restriction, it's like possibility to the consumer, is additional right to the consumer. So consumer within 2 calendar days could may withdraw from the consumer credit agreement without any consequences for the consumer. So so the third institute we would like to discuss the stop list. So and this list is managed by the Bank of Lithuania and it began functioning on November 2016. Later when law changed to the law came into force, and creditors they are not allowed or prohibited to lend or to conclude the agreements with the persons who are included in this stop list. And in case of breach, this agreement would be treated as invalid and the creditor would be subject to a fine, administrative fine. And the person, they can be included in this list on their own request or on the basis of court decision in case they abuse his rights his or her rights to conclude consumer credit agreement. And the person who can apply to the court, so it's like spouse, like children, or prosecutor. So he or she has such right. So a bit statistic about this stop list. We do not have newest statistic, but we can see what happened during the first 2 months in November, December of 2016. So almost 300 persons were included to this list, and 201 men and almost 100 women. And the oldest person was 89, it's interesting, and the youngest 18 years old. And you can decide on the period on which you, during which you do not want to conclude the agreement, so, but statistically our average period is five years. And FAVE Institute, we would like to discuss everything. So, oh, no, sorry, this is final. And so we should conclude that there is clearly a clear relation between these changes and...